In the world of romantic entanglements, the people fall into two separate yet equal groups. Those who pursue meaningful long-term relationships, and those who are just trying to fuck. These are their stories.
Oh God, Lauren, don't even bother with brunch there. The wait is horrendous, and the mimosas are ratchet.
OMG, I hate ratchet mimosas.
Body's never easy. What do we got here?
Caucasian male, early 20s, multiple stab wounds to the chest, contusions on the head and arms, ligature marks around the neck indicating strangulation. Also, bullet wound to the right temple and defensive wounds on the hands indicating struggle.
Looks like suicide to me.
We're not ruling it out.
Say, was there any chance of poison?
No sign of poison, sir.
Good, I just wanted to make sure there wasn't any chance of there being any poison.
Poison!
Well, let's just plant a gun on them and get out of here. Master Chef Junior's on in 20. It's a rerun, but I think it's going to be a pretty good episode.
All right, I'm certain.
Breaking news. Patricia Weathers here. Newsflash, murder in the bayou. And I'm not talking about when people ask, can I buy you a drink? But you already knew that because we are in the South and we all know what a bayou is. All we know right now is that there's a body, murdered, probably. First on the scene is my stupid sister, Gail Weathers. Don't listen to her. She's not smart and balanced in her reporting like me. Gail?
Gail Weathers here. Jimmy Sugarbaker was found here at 6 a.m. by morning joggers. Police have yet to find any evidence of foul play, but come on. His mother and girlfriend are left in the wake of this carnage. Are more murders to come? Almost certainly. Is this the work of a serial killer? You'll have to stay tuned to find out. Gail Weathers, WWJD Precision News.
It's kinda hard when you're not around. Know you're in heaven, smiling down. Watch us as we pray for you. Every day we pray for you. Till the day we meet again. In our hearts, it's oil in my friend. I'm giving thing to hear half a breath. I know you're still living life
every
after death.
Every breath I take. Oh. Every move I make.
What?
Every single day. Every time I pray, I'm missing you.
Oh, Jimmy.
Blythe Barrington, psychic detective. I know this is kind of awkward, but did someone close to you die recently?
Yes, my son recently passed.
Well, I know this might sound strange, but I think I'm getting messages from the beyond.
I get those all the time. What's the big deal?
Really?
Yeah, I just throw them away. I mean, how many Keurigs do you really need?
No, you're thinking about Bed Bath & Beyond. I'm talking about the beyond, like the other side.
No, I don't follow.
You know, where we all must go someday? The undiscovered country?
The final frontier. Like in Star Trek!
Death! I'm talking about death! I speak to dead people, you mouth-breathing hill folk. God!
Well, I'm afraid we've already hired someone to assist us with this line of inquiry. we mouth-breathing hill folk prevent to focus on the terrestrial plane. We leave the ineffable to you Yankees and your alienation from the corporeal.
Yeah.
Get it?
Yeah, you're not effable. Corporeal means fat, right?
Sure, dear. Now be a dear, go fetch the detective, please. That's about it. She is, cause my gem is a petite ami. Allow me to introduce
Pamela Sparrow, P.I. Miss Sugarbaker has retained me to look into the death of her son.
Yeah, whatever. Oh, Miss Sugarbaker, I'm getting something. It's your son. He's saying, oh, mama, don't trust this ugly woman with the bad hair. Talk to this strapping young lad instead.
Hey, settle down, Suze Orman cosplayer. I don't need your shit. I'm from the mean streets of New York City. Ever heard of it, pal?
Yeah, I've heard of New York City.
The Big Apple! The city that never sleeps. The land of a thousand dances. A blood-soaked concrete jungle where only the strong survive.
Oh, so that's why you left, you weakling.
Hey, I found the Doubloonbergs. Mayor Bloomberg's secret Spanish doubloons. What have you ever done?
Well, I use my third eye to see into that which is unknowable.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm third eye blind. You can put the past away. I don't need little ghost pals to solve a murder. I just use my gut. Anything you can do, I can do better.
Well, I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
Well, I'm sure we could just do this all day, but as my old dear departed, Mr. Sugarbaker used to say, this old swamp rat carcass isn't gonna tie itself to the bedpost. Y'all both go together down to the crime scene, see what clues y'all can rustle up.
To the crime scene? Spamela, was it? Where's the crime scene exactly? I don't care about bagels. The gluten interferes with my extrasensory perception, okay?
We're here.
Yeah, I know, I felt it.
Of course you did. Oh my god! You actually use a crystal ball? How horrendously cliche. Aha! A pink ribbon. Maybe the killer was a ribbon dancer. There's some sort of brown residue over here.
Ignore Pamela. She does this all the time. Listen, I don't normally do this, but can I solve your murder?
Who are you talking to?
Jimmy.
Jimmy the dead guy?
Yeah. He's right here.
Fine, you do your crazy thing. I'll solve a murder, why don't I? Okay, I think I will. God.
So, Jimmy, tell me, did it hurt when you fell from heaven? Because... you know, you died and then went to heaven and then came back to Earth to avenge your death. Oh, no. You can't feel pain. I love that about you.
Will you stop? There's nothing there. Ghosts aren't real.
Well, pardon me, Christopher Bitchens. You can't just see what's right in front of you.
The only thing in front of me right now is a delusional nitwit with his ball in his hand.
Oh, you want to go, Pam? You want to go?
Bring it on,
you want to go?
Bitch.
Let's
this crime scene for 15 minutes just waiting for somebody to return to it, and our patience has paid off. You're all coming with us!
Come on now.
Use both private eyes?
No, I'm a private third eye.
Oh, dear God.
So if I'm understanding this correctly, you're some kind of Chris Angel psychic mind freak, huh? Well, then tell me something, Chris Angel. What am I thinking of right now?
Pussy.
Hell yeah! Oh, witch!
Some real mind freakery. All right, I'm getting something. I'm getting the letter E.
Statistically, the most common letter in the English language.
My grandmother, her name, it was Alice Letter E.
Yeah, Alice Letter E, exactly. And she's sending me something about food.
She ate food! How did you know?
And she's talking about your favorite dish, the one she always used to make you.
Them Pop-Tarts that taste like s'mores.
Yeah, the Pop-Tarts that taste like s'mores. And she really wants to make them for you again, and she loves you, and she wants you to let me go.
Deputy, set this man free.
With all due respect, Sheriff, this man is clearly playing you for a drongo.
A what now?
Well, it's a fool. My stepmother's Australian, I just have to pick up on some meridians, that's it.
Oh yeah, like, oh mate, throw some shrimp on the barbie!
No! They wouldn't say that, they call shrimp prawns over there. No one ever say that.
Well shit man, all this talk about shrimp got me hungry for that instead of Pop-Tarts. Hey, didn't I tell you to uncuff him? Get the cum out your ears, boy. Alright, we're going down to Shack tomorrow, get English shrimp. All come right, on, now. Y'all.
Hello? Still handcuffed to a chair over here. You can't just leave me. I can do dumb magic tricks too.
So, hey, funny story. I just came here to not steal files and solve a murder. Definitely not that. And no am I here to get a big scoop that'll expose police incompetence and move me up to the big leagues, journalism-wise. Not doing that.
That's fine, I don't care.
Really?
Yeah, I'm a private detective. We hate the cops. If you uncuff me, I'll even help you get my story. I mean, your story. I mean, our story.
You're handcuffed to the chair?
Yeah, apparently I was interfering with a crime scene, whatever that means. And they just left me here to go get endless shrimp, I think.
What?
ACAB, bro.
You know what? I like your style. We should team up. Team up selfie!
So, Jimmy left around 9:30?
Yes, he went to breakfast at the Shack de Mo, where he wouldn't say with who.
Oh, well, that's probably nothing.
Really?
No! It's very suspicious.
In fact, I'd go as far as say it's a first clue. First clue selfie.
Do you know where he went after that?
Well, I know he was going to see Betty at some point.
How'd they get along?
Oh, well enough, I suppose. When Jimmy went to college, I'd always assumed he'd outgrown her. Well, apparently not. Confidentially, she is a real bitch. And I am not talking about a female dog.
Yeah, I know. We know what a bitch
well,
is.
Well, she never treated my Jimmy right, in my opinion. Sleeping around, spending his money, my money, really. Always ordering water without ice because of her precious sensitive teeth. But I gotta tell you,
Jimmy's death has been really good for our relationship. We've never been closer.
Betty has.
Lady Jimmy, wait. A few days before the murder, she did buy a gun. And she's been asking me about life insurance. And she's been watching Murder, She Wrote obsessively and taking notes. But no, I don't think she could have done it.
You're probably right. Gail, can I see over here for a sec? So, she definitely did it, right?
Oh, yeah.
I think it's time we pay Betty a little visit.
Yeah, slice her up. Street justice.
No, just talk to her.
All right. Hey, Mr. Psychic Man, I got another one for you. Tell me, using your psychic powers, what's in my po' boy?
Well, I saw you order it, and the whole time over here you were singing, tramp, 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 tramp.
If it's too hard, you can just give up.
It's shrimp.
He done it again.
Say, what can you tell me about our waitress?
Oh, who, Bonnie? Well, we went to elementary school together, middle school, junior high school, junior college, community college, Bible camp, yes. Church camp, Polytechnic, Alcoholics Anonymous, and Lamaze together, but we're not really what you call close.
See, they're about as close as a wallaby and a wombat. Oh, they're not close because they live in different habitats.
That's an excellent metaphor, Deputy.
Thanks, sir.
Hey, what you wondering about Bond for, anyway?
Hey, you get one of them psychic visions or something?
Did she do the murder? Bond, Bond, you are under arrest, girl!
Refill my coffee and put your hands on your head.
No. Guys, look. I just want to ask her a few questions, okay?
Well, anything you can do to help us not do our jobs, we're happy to help you do that thing.
All right. Bonnie, was it? Was Jimmy Sugarbaker in here recently?
Look, hon, I see a lot of people in here.
No, you know Jimmy, the guy who was murdered, like, 2 weeks ago. You know, like, cut, like, really ripped, you know, like, piercing eyes like he's got a secret, and the secret is that he loves you.
Oh, Jimmy! Jimmy, yeah, you know, I think he was in here recently, but I don't remember much.
Anything at all. We're just trying to bring his murderer to justice.
Hey, Bonnie, speaking of justice, this cup is just ice and could use a little more Dr. Pepper.
I'll be right with you, hon. So, anyway, I was saying, I don't remember too much. Let's see, he came in here last Thursday night at 9:26 p.m. with his girlfriend. He ordered the John Gritter, that's grits on Johnny Cakes. Mm-hmm. They talked about life insurance policies, you know, puppy love stuff. And they got in some kind of argument, and I couldn't make everything out. But at the end, she yelled, "Jimmy Sugarbaker, I swear to God and anyone listening, I'm going to murder you."
Anything else?
Well, 2 days later, he came in again with Mr. Frisbee.
Hold on a second. You talking about Dick Frisbee, the Laundry King?
That's him. They, the two of them came in to carb down after a CrossFit session.
Okay, so what was Jimmy wearing? And how sweaty was he?
Well, he was wearing some black lycra shorts, a University of Alabama tank top.
Roll Tide!
And he was looking more ripped than a flyer for a lawn mowing service. You know, those flyers with the little numbers at the bottom? He just...
Okay, now we're getting somewhere.
Yeah. So anyway, he came in with Mr. Frisbee. They both ordered the steak a picture, it'll last longer. It's just a normal steak, but we encourage you to Instagram it. And I do remember Dick Frisbee yelling something like, "I swear on my love of moonshine, I will fucking murder you."
Wait, is everyone here just threatening to murder one another all the time?
You know, I never thought about it, but I'd guesstimate I hear about 5 or 6 a day.
Sheriff, do you ever investigate these constant threats of murder?
I don't know how it works where you come from, but around here we got something called the First Amendment. And that protects freedom of speech. There's nothing illegal about just saying you're gonna murder somebody.
Well, I could be wrong. I think attempted murder's okay, as long as it's a form of, how do you call it, performance art.
Do you see Betty and her pack of cronies anywhere?
Over there. Could she really have killed him?
Well, there she is. Let's ask her.
Hey, Betty, isn't that Jimmy's ring you're wearing?
Uh-huh.
Gee, it must be hard carrying on. By the way, where'd you meet him?
I met him in the candy store. He turned around and smiled at me. You get the picture?
Yeah, we see.
That's when I fell for the leader of the pack. My folks were always putting him down. They said he came from the wrong side of town.
What do you mean they said they came from the wrong side of town?
They told me he was bad, but I knew he was sad. That's why I fell for the leader of the pack.
The last time I saw him was about 9 p.m. Then I went straight home, asked anyone. As he drove away on that rainy night, I begged him to go slow. Whether he heard me, I'll never know.
No, no, no.
Look out, look out, look out, look out!
I felt so helpless, what could I do? Remembering all the things we'd been through. At school they all stop and stare. I try to hide the tears, but I don't care. I'll never forget him, the leader of the pack.
Wasn't on the bayou, it was in a park. And I don't mean park like park your car, I mean park like on Parks and Recreation. Except, spoiler alert, no one dies on that show, except little Sebastian! Just to clarify. Oh, this just in though, one time my sister Gail told me that she was vegan but that fish was okay. Newsflash, if you eat fish, you are not vegan!
Okay. Here's what we found. Wait a minute. Since when are you guys in cahoots?
Well, Blythe's been communing with my Jimmy at the Bed Bath and Beyond. And he got vital clues from a waitress. And he knew I was thinking about a pussy. Real deal, I swear.
I am so lost.
Yes, I'm
come up with what exactly?
Two suspects and two vital clues. That's pretty good for one day.
I'm Shamala. I think crimes are solved with evidence and deduction. Oh, Miss Sugarbaker. Oh, I'm getting another vision that you're losing trust in Shamala over here.
It's true, I am losing trust.
All right, everyone. I think it's time we hold a seance. We need to communicate with Jimmy directly, because there are some things only he can tell us. Like, who killed him? Can ghosts go out for coffee? And what are his turn-ons?
A seance? Are you kidding me? What's next? Oh, I know, I got it. We'll be getting the murder weapon out of a child's ear.
Could that work?
I was being facetious.
For what now? Look here, college, not all of us knows what words mean, all right? How am I supposed to be able to see something if I don't even know what that is? And another thing, who the hell are you?
Oh, yeah, sure. This is Shamala. Shamala Fartface.
Shamala Fartface, huh? Didn't we arrest someone named Pamela this morning that was about her height?
Yes, sir.
My twin sister?
Shamala? And Pamela Fartface?
Yeah, that's us, the Fartface twins. Shamala and Pamela.
Sam's got some weird names, man.
Alright, I've gathered you all here to open the lines of communication between us and Jimmy.
Wait, he lose his phone or something?
Oh god, he was murdered!
Oh shit, I had a brain fart. Sorry for your loss.
Alright, we're gonna try to contact the spirit realm, because Jimmy can communicate some things to us that only he knows. Like, if there's anyone that he finds particularly attractive in the living world.
Well, wait. But I thought contacting the dead was against the Bible.
Actually, the Pope just declared that seances were perfectly fine.
I love this new Pope.
That's fine if you're Catholic, but we're Baptists.
Well, he said it was fine for Baptists too, so just don't worry. You're pretty little. Now, everyone, please stand in a circle and let's join hands.
Oh, if we holding hands, I'm going to get between two girls.
Oh! No. Why are your hands feel like that?
They feel rough and callous because I work, ma'am. I go out there every day, and I bust my hump, and I risk my rump to keep the rest of you safe.
No. Why are they so sticky?
They're sticky because in the line of an investigation, I found some old gummy bears in a shirt pocket, and they were melting from going through the dryer.
Sheriff, the sooner you stop interrupting this, the sooner you can go back to not working, okay?
10-4, psychic buddy.
All right, everyone. The key to a successful seance is for everyone to believe in it. If we don't believe, it won't work, okay? So now everyone believe, concentrate, think about Jimmy and his pecs, and I will invoke him with the power of song.
Do you believe?
Do you believe?
Okay, who's not believing?
Oh, shit, I was thinking about pussy. Oh, shit, me too.
I was thinking about how this is a waste of time.
All right, concentrate, everyone. And think about Jimmy.
No matter how hard I try, you keep pushing me aside and I can't break through. There's no talking to you. So It takes time with bereaving. Come on, Jimmy, break on through. I really need to talk to you. Oh, do you believe in love after life? I can feel something within me say, I really need to know about that night now. Do you believe in love after life? I can feel something within me say, I really need.
Yes, Mother! I'm fine, by the way. Thanks for asking.
Oh, Jimmy, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Maybe if I was a better mother, you wouldn't go running around with those whores and laundromatists.
I forgive you, Mother, and I forgive you for making everything be about you all of the time. Oh, God, it seems as almost as if I have to fade away now.
Jimmy, before you go, tell us. Who murdered you?
Catfish killed me.
What? Catfish? You choked on catfish?
I can't stay in this plane. I have to go back.
Wait, before you leave, will you go out with me?
You just asked me out in front of my mom? This is so awkward!
He's gone. He didn't even say goodbye.
Well, at least we know Diane didn't teach him any respect for his poor old mother.
So, Senor Sakisimo, what's the plan now?
There was no plan. He was hoping Jimmy would solve his own murder so he could get all the glory and the ghost dick, apparently.
Well, good thing I hire you then. What are you going to do to solve the murder?
Talk to Dick Frisbee, for starters.
Okay, and then?
Stupid ghost won't stupid love me. Why are all the hot ones flakes? Or is it just me? Am I only attracted to ghosts because they're unavailable? Am I gonna be alone forever? I learned the truth at 17. That love was meant for beauty queens. Oh, hey. I mean, oh, hey.
Hey, I just wanted to say I'm sorry about back there.
I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, you asked me out in front of my mother during a seance, and I kind of freaked out because when I had a life, I wasn't really that into dudes, but anyway. About that date?
Yeah.
I'd love to.
Yay!
I'm telling you, I don't know nothing.
A double negative. He knows something.
We have witnesses.
Sure. I saw Jimmy the day he died.
What of it?
We do CrossFit together almost every day. Except the Sabbath, it wouldn't be right pumping on the Lord's Day.
We heard you were getting real friendly with young Jimmy.
Perhaps too friendly.
I'm all man. My stuff works and everything. Ask anybody.
About your stuff?
You know, my stuff. My boys, my vital essence.
We get it.
I don't get it.
Listen, could a pansy knock up a friend's girlfriend? Riddle me that.
Wait, what? Who did you impregnate?
I've said too much. Before I know it, I'll spill the beans about my illegal moonshine business and my mafia ties.
Moonshine? Mafia ties?
Beans?
Gotta go.
Almost
it.
This whole place hangs on Dick.
So maybe you rode Dick too hard.
If anything, I was too soft.
Yeah, you can't come at him soft when he's coming at you so hard.
That's right.
I've been there, man.
Well, maybe you next time should play Dick hot and cold.
I'm gonna come down on Dick so hard. This hole, I'm just gonna blow the whole thing wide open.
You gotta jerk him around a little bit first. Have him on his knees.
No. Man, next time I see Dick, I'm just gonna take that boy and beat him till he is just red and spitting up all over the place.
I wish someone was filming this.
Let's not get bent out of shape over Dick. What was that he said about impregnating a friend's girlfriend?
Well, he does only have one friend.
Jimmy Sugarbaker!
This whole time, Betty's been lying to us about being pregnant with Dick Frisbee's baby. Sheriff, bring her in.
Now hold on there, missy. Last time I checked, I wear the badge. Who put you in charge of this investigation? And at what point did you become in charge of this investigation?
Mrs. Sugarbaker, and after the seance.
Well, that checks out. All right, let's go. Let's do it.
Hey, there's Lauren, one of the girls who found Jimmy Sugarbaker's body. We tried to interview her for the news, but her voice really freaked out the canines who were on the scene. It was like the whole thing.
I got it. I speak basic.
I got it. I know, right? Lauren, I heard you found the body. That must have been like so...
It was seriously so much.
I mean, I'm like, whatever, seriously, when people are like, honestly, seriously, for real, honestly.
It feels so good to hear you say that, because like, when the cops came, it took them like 2 hours, and Lauren and I missed our spinning class.
No one has suffered like you have suffered.
And the whole place reeked.
Wow.
Yeah. It kind of smelled like the basements at Tridel after a mixer. You know, it was totally ratchet.
No, that's not your word. You don't say that. All right, gotta go. She said it smelled like cheap alcohol at the crime scene.
Moonshine?
Maybe moonshine.
Well, I'm happy to report that the suspect is in custody.
Did you handcuff somebody to a chair and then leave them in a police station?
Maybe.
How'd you know about that?
Let's not worry about what I know and what I don't know. Now, here's what I know. The crime scene smelled like moonshine.
Huh, moonshine. It did have a distinct odor. Hey, where's my new psychic best friend? He should be getting in on all this sleuthing we're doing.
Oh, he's got his ghost date, remember?
Ghost date? Mm-hmm. Oh, that spells trouble. You mark my words. That ain't gonna end good at all.
It's a ghost color. It's kind of between grism and clump. You can't see it with your mortal eyes.
Oh, that's fascinating. I love colors. You know, I'm trying to integrate more into my wardrobe because my friend said that we in the New Age community have kind of taken this whole all-black trend too far, and it's really just restricting our auras. It's time for something new.
Oh yeah, time. That's meaningless to me.
Oh, that's cool.
Can you feel the love tonight? It is where we are. It's enough for this wide-eyed wanderer that we got this far.
this here is your lifeline. Oh, it's really short. Oh, I guess it would be. So, I don't know, do you like any TV shows?
Well, it's kind of embarrassing, but MasterChef Junior?
No, I love that show!
You're the best part about being a ghost is.
Is it that you're freed from all physical wants and needs and thus have no longer disappointment?
Way better than that. I know who won this season.
Oh my god, you have to tell me!
Well, all I can say is it's not who you expect it would be.
Aw, poor Vance. Tennessee's gayest 9-year-old doesn't win.
Hey, don't put labels on kids, weirdo.
I'm not weird, you're weird, you're dead.
Last time I checked, there are way more dead people than living. You're in the minority.
So what you're really saying is that I'm unique, right? Do you really think I'm weird?
A little bit, but you're also sweet.
You know what my favorite part of MasterChef Junior is?
Oh, Gordon Ramsay
is so supportive
of the kids!
He's just so gentle with them.
Yeah, it's like you see a whole new side of him. And, you know, you see someone every day, and then
they surprise you.
Can you feel the love tonight? It's enough to make kings and vagabonds believe the very best. And if he falls in love tonight, it can be assumed he'll love the dead and live in history. Should I buy his
dude? The jig is up, Betty. We know about your relationship with Dick Frisbee and the baby.
No, it's true! My house... My life has become a house of lies!
On one thing. Pamela Sparrow getting into the mix to the mansion!
Hey, that's so Raven. The true detective wants us over at the Sugarbaker estate ASAP. I reckon she's cracked the case.
Hold on, deputy. I'm trying to reroute the encryption code and access the mainframe on Jimmy's computer.
Son, I'm not sure that's how computers work.
I'm in! All right. Let's go to his Google search history. All right. Megan Fox naked. Georgia CrossFit. All right. Hugh Jackman naked. What if my friend is gay and can men like dongs? Is that a thing? I guess that makes sense. All right, what's this? Bushbuddies.com? Australia's number one single mingle, let's get down, under, and dirty.
We should really be going.
Hold on a minute. I think I just found his chat logs with someone named Kraken Fatties. What is that? Oh, it's just a whole lot of dicks. I guess it's Australian slang for get a boner?
Well, I could have told you that, you numpty.
Well, sorry, Mr. Cosmopolitan. Gosh. All right. What dirty shit is Jimmy into? Whew. Jimmy, I was into dudes, my ass, my firm, shapely buttocked ass. Deputy, you've got to listen to this. Quoth Jimmy,
All of this CrossFit has made my thighs thick as tree trunks. I'm gonna wrap them around your and just go.
All right, that's enough.
Is this too hot for you or something?
No, I just really think we need to get to that Sugarbaker estate. I reckon Miss Sparrow's got the good oil on our killer.
Oh, yeah, the good oil. That. All right, I think I'm ready, Deputy.
Why I've gathered you here.
Didn't you figure out the killer or something?
Everyone in here had a motive to kill Jimmy Sugarbaker.
I didn't. Oh no, Miss Blocker, you most of all. The infidelity, the secret pregnancy, it all points to mistrust and murder, perhaps? Or perhaps not. And you, Chesty LePetamine. Your loyalty to Miss Blocker knew no bounds. You'd go to the ends of the earth for her, or maybe the electric chair.
Nah, bitch can rot for all I care.
Why, fuck you!
Fun fact, Betty, I also slept with Jimmy.
What, you skank?
Moving on.
Camellia Sugarbaker.
Sweet, old, doddering, old, frail.
Oh, sweet Jesus, just kill me now!
Your golden years were eclipsed by a little birdie that wouldn't leave the nest. Maybe he needed a push into the grave!
That's ridiculous! I hired you!
Aha! The perfect cover! And you! Sheriff Bruno Mars!
Present!
You're too stupid to have done this. You're cool.
I think you're innocent, too.
Thanks, thank you. Which leads me to Blythe Barrington. A psychic detective. So lonely, so homely, so desperate for attention. Could he have committed a crime that only he could possibly solve?
No.
You wouldn't kill to have a boyfriend?
Figuratively, sure.
And I figure you committed a murder.
What? Why would I investigate a murder if the police have already ruled it a suicide?
Will you just let me have this? I have to accuse everyone before my big j'accuse.
Your big j'accuse?
Yeah, when I j'accuse someone.
No, j'accuse means I accuse you. You would be saying, I accuse you, you.
Exactly. I accuse you, you! Dick Frisbee. It was you that was running the moonshine. It was you who impregnated Betty. You were running a money laundering scheme out of your laundromat, Eureka. And you Eureka lies. I got the idea when Gail said, when Dick put his coin in your slot. Dirty money goes in, clean change comes out. The perfect crime until Jimmy found out he was blackmailing you. Dirty money, clean money. It didn't matter to Jimmy Sugarbaker. He was a liability, a stain on your life you had to remove. But no matter how hot the rinse cycle, you can't wash the blood from your hands.
Wrong.
I didn't kill Jimmy.
Yeah, huh?
I was taking Betty to her OBGYN appointment.
It's true. Dr. Joachim's receptionist can confirm it.
Shit.
What a lovely way of saying how much you love her. What a lovely way of saying that you're thinking of me. I can see it. Your face is glowing. I can see it in your eyes. Are you happy to know it? That you're having my baby. I'm a woman in love and I love what it's doing to me. Having my baby.
see it showing. Oh, my seed inside you, baby, do you feel it growing? Are you happy to know it, that you're having my baby? I'm a woman in love, and I love what it's doing to me. Having my baby. I'm a woman in love, and I love what's going through me. Come on, baby.
Murder is a delicate operation. There are the practicalities to consider. When to do it, with what weapon, even who to kill. But we all know this. There is another part of murder that is a little more tricky, and that's deception. Who to frame, with what frame? Does the frame match the carpet?
Did the carpet match the drapes?
Jimmy's murderer had to be able to live a lie. They had to be able to adopt a completely different consciousness at will. And who could navigate two separate worlds with such facility? Oh, I don't know. Maybe someone with an Australian stepmother. Deputy Cam Scanner, or shall I say, Cameron Skinner. You're no local boy made good at all. You're really an Australian plumber, and you wanted to lay your pipe right into Jimmy Sugarbaker. Yes.
Of course.
He was catfishing you. He went on an Australian dating website pretending to be an Aussie expat in America. He led you on, and you just couldn't take it. Rather than accept that Jimmy was perhaps experimenting with his latent homosexuality, you had to have your catfish served up Australian style. That is, battered and fried.
Sully, you finally figured it out. Yeah, I killed Jimmy. I'd do it again, too. The bloke fed me so much raw prawn, he might as well have been a fishing boat.
Raw prawn is Australian slang for bullshit.
Oh, squeeze the clever night hooper! Jimmy gave me the runaround. Online, he was as romantic as a kangaroo, in love with another kangaroo. But in reality, he was just a wombat in an emu's clothing. A deadly huntsman spider masquerading as a slightly less deadly common garden orb weaver spider. We should have been skiing in the mountains of Alabama by now.
Alabama doesn't have mountains.
Just one of the many lies he told me. Sold everything I had, down to my last boomerang. Came over here to try to get some answers. I've seen things that you blokes wouldn't believe. Anzac ships off the coast of Brisbane. I've seen Aurora Australis glitter in the dark near Ayers Rock. All those moments will be lost in time, like tears in rain. Time to die. Sheriff?
What?
Were you sleeping through my confession?
No, I was paying attention through your confession.
You were snoring.
Well, that's my paying attention noises.
You threw off my whole flow. I just can't do it anymore. I don't have it in me.
Oh, come on, man. Keep on confessing.
Fine. I spied on him. I found out about his girlfriend and various other lovers. I murdered him. And then I planted evidence implicating each and every one of you, etc., etc., etc. I thought I had you bleeding health privatizers fooled. Tell me, psychic. How'd you figure it out?
Well, let's just say I know what ghosts like.
No, not that. How'd you figure out the real murder weapon?
How'd I do what now?
Eh, the strangulation, the stabbing, the bludgeoning. How'd you know how I really did it?
I think I can answer that question. If I was you, I'd get a lawyer before you think of leaving the state. It's so deadly when love is not connected to your fate. He was so fly, he drove you right out of your mind and stole your heart. You started scheming, he ate that toast you made him. He fell to the ground, he was screaming, and who? Just to clarify, poison. He poisoned him. The brown residue I found on the crime scene was Vegemite that was poisoned with, like, I don't know, spider venom. Spider venom! Got it in one. This song starting again, deadly place. That's why it's hard. Nope. Snake bite, spider bite, Vegemite. That dude used poison. Never trust a big butt and a smile. You know, we've had fun here, but I just want to say one thing. Gail, we've been sleuthing and truthing and finding ourselves. Will you marry me?
Yes!
She said yes!
Yeah!
All right. All right.
Am I under arrest?
Oh, you're
shit,
so
you're
under arrest.
Oh, cups, get out of here, you!
The city breathes a sigh of relief. Because the Parks and Recreation killer has been caught. Sheriff's Deputy Cam Scanner has pled guilty to all charges. And I don't mean charges on a credit card. I'm frugal, not like my spendthrift sister, Gail. I'm getting new information that Gail wants to be called Buttface. Back to you, Buttface.
Your words can't hurt me anymore, Patricia. Newsflash, guess who's the first sister to get engaged? Fuck you, Pat. Monday morning, I'm off to New York City to work for Highlights News. Can you tell the difference between these two pictures? Answer at 11.
Wow, Gail, slut it up much? Update, Gail Weathers. More like Gail Force Winds, because she is such a blowhard. I'm Patricia Weathers, and this has been a news broadcast. Good night.
Thank you so much for letting us solve your son's murder.
Who knew such a tragedy could bring such joy into our lives?
Oh, it warms my heart seeing all you queers violating the sanctity of our institution. But it's got me wondering something. Camellia, can I call you Cam?
Oh, no, please don't.
Cammy, true love is a young person's game. We both know that. You and I, we've been around the block a couple times. We even parked the car. We know the store. We even kept track of how many runners on base a particular pitcher had during the first part of the season, but I was just wondering if this old bag of bones right here could take this other bag of bones right there, and you make me the happiest bag of bones in this here county.
Oh, Sheriff, that's just bless your heart, but at this point in my life, I too prefer the V to the D.
It doesn't hurt to ask.
Well, with all you gum chews gone, it's gonna be so sad around here. It's just gonna be like a molasses factory.
here. You just gotta believe that things will get better. Let me help you through the grieving process, you old gator cooch.
And I know that you'll get through this, 'cause I know that you are strong. You don't need us anymore. No, you don't need us anymore. You don't need us anymore. No, you don't need us anymore. Yes, we believe in something beyond me say, happy Valentine's Day, oh, yes, we believe in love after life, I can feel something beyond me say, happy Valentine's Day,
Thank you, everybody. Let's bring up our writer.
Well, the lights are off, but that doesn't work. Thank you so much for coming. This was the best time. I'm sorry, is it too loud?
Louder.
Even louder. I'm not gonna do that. I want to thank the bank door. We want to thank our sound engineer, Colin Jenkins, our ethereal voice. We want to thank Crystal, again, ethereal voice. We want to thank Kim in absentia, who brought her perfect Kimness to it. Janelle for the lights and Lindsay for the props. And we want to thank you all because, as William always says, you're the real stars.